We pray as well for those who have been injured on the battlefield and must fight daily the battles that as they bear firsthand the wounds of war. And in remembering the sacrifice of all who have served, Lord, we ask that you help each of us to be inspired to greater sacrifice of ourselves in ways that can benefit others and our nation and the cause of peace in our world. Lord, you are Lord of your kingdom of love and peace and justice. We pray that you bless this memorial and that it may be for years to come a sign of remembrance of all those courageous men and women who have fought for our nation, and a sign of the call that you give to us to move forward in your grace and your hope, building your kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever.
Thank you, Father. Some of you may have noticed the American flag that is flying today is not a normal nylon flag that the other flags are. Let me explain. Len Klein was a World War II Navy veteran and a member of both the North St. Paul American Legion and Veterans of Foreign Wars. Len spent a good portion of his life looking after the flags in North St. Paul and making sure that flag etiquette was being followed. Len and his family would place flags up and down 7th Street in the spring and then take them down in the fall. Len would visit our local schools and speak to our children about Americanism and what it means to be an American. Len, regrettably, is no longer physically with us. So we are honoring his commitment to Americanism and his vigilance by having his flag be the first American flag to officially be raised over this park. His flag will be replaced and returned to his family with our thanks. I want to introduce today's special guests. They include Congresswoman Betty McCollum, State Senator Charles Wigger, State Representative Leon Lilly, North St. Paul Mayor Michael Keane, North St. Paul Council members Terry Furlong, Candy Peterson, Jan Walzek, and Tom Sonic. I would also like to recognize the North St. Paul Veterans Park Committee, and I would appreciate as I call your name that you would stand. Co-chairman Dan Fisher and Carl Hurchin. Secretary Joe Zakruski. Our members at large, Paul Anderson, Don Schroeder, Dave Angren, the late Bill Crowther, and our lawyer, John Baker. I want to thank all the committee, which I'm a part of, for their hard work in making an idea into a reality. To date, the committee has sold 732 individual pavers, 37 group pavers, and 5 benches, totaling with other donations $138,676.74. With the bonding money from the state and the legacy money of $109,900, the total raised as of today is $244,556.74. This is not bad for a group of volunteers. The pavers are still available and you can get them at City Hall, the Veterans Foreign Wars, and the American Legion. Thank you, gentlemen. One other name I glazed over is Ellsworth Erickson. Ellsworth was at the very beginning of this back in, I believe it was 1986. Thank you very much. Representing our future, representing our past and present, we have representatives from our Veteran Service Group, the North St. Paul American Legion Post 39, and Arthur O'Houghlin, Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 1350. Representing our future, the North High School Junior ROTC, the Air Force instructor, Master Sergeant Brian Biskins, First Lieutenant Alan Bierskin, Second Lieutenant Muhad Omar, Second Lieutenant Patrick Anderson, Tech Sergeant Eric Berglund, and Master Sergeant Ike Alice Alexson. Additionally, we would like to thank the city's team of City Manager Jason Zimmer, Scott Dudek, Lori Canelli, and the entire city staff for all their help in seeing this project to a successful completion. We are also lucky in having local businesses help out with major donations and advertising and in-kind donations. Some of their names are listed in your program. In addition to those names, I would like to thank the Herchin family, the Military Order of Purple Heart, Anchor Bank, the St. Paul Disabled Veterans Chapter, the First Shot Naval Vets, Premier Bank, the AmVets Department of Minnesota, the North St. Paul Business and Professional Association, the Sons of the American Legion Squadron 39, Tracy Luther Auction, Gary Insurance Center, the North St. Paul High School Class of 1963, the Frank Fratto family, the North St. Paul Maplewood and Oakdale Rotary, the Burwald Roofing, the Erickson family, the North St. Paul Fire Department, Thorson, Breedinger, and Novak, La Garage Gallery, the National Wild Turkey Federation, the Kinswald family, Ideal Credit Union, the Knights of Columbus, Reflex Medical, Sandberg's Mortuary, Window World Twin Cities, Lily News, and JJ Distributing for purchasing the group pavers and a score of other things they have done in their ongoing support of this park. Lastly, and the biggest thanks go to you, the individual people who donated and purchased individual pavers. Without all of your support, this project never would have happened. Thank you very much. Just to clarify, this is not a memorial park. This is a veterans park that contains a memorial. On the granite panels below the flags in your front, there are a list of killed in action and POW MIA names from every conflict from World War I to the present. There is a saying you may have heard, that freedom is not free. This list of North St. Paulites are people who in their respective conflicts have given their full measure so that freedom can continue to ring. With the assistance of Joe Zakreski, we will recognize their sacrifice. From World War I, Mary Cummings. Leroy Flint. Arthur O. Hawkland. Emil Troutman, Emil Newman. Rudolph Shockey. Frank Stepnitz. Otto Troutman. Harold Dean. Earl Peters. And Owen Pearson. From World War II, Martin Thiel Jr. Walter H. Young. William F. Carth. Eldon Keane. Richard E. Newman. Richard K. Notebart. Cletus J. Gumbold. Robert Cassidy. And Myron M. Zamansky. From Korea, Roger H. Hale. William C. Bendorf. Ernest C. Dopner. From Vietnam, Stephen R. Bauer. James T. Pro. Douglas C. Merrill. Kale A. Solberg. Eugene D. Spicer. James F. Malloy. Bernard T. Hansen. And Roger W. Swanson, MIA. From Iraq, Gregory F. Rundell. And from Afghanistan, Matthew J. Johnson. And Chad D. Froker. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and remove your headgear for the rendering of honors to the fallen by the North St. Paul Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 1350 Rifle Squad and Fort Snelling Bugler Tom Mullen. Rifle Squad Captain render appropriate honors to the fallen. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Our guest speakers for today are U.S. Congresswoman Representative Betty McCollum, State Senator Charles Wigger, State Representative Leon Lilly, North St. Paul Mayor Mike Keene, North St. Paul City Council Member Terry Furlong, and co-chairman of the North St. Paul Veterans Park, Inc., Dan Fisher. In break with protocol and tradition, we feel it appropriate to have the co-chairman, Dan Fisher, of the North St. Paul Veterans Park, Inc., be the first speaker today. Dan Fisher is a Marine who served our country honorably and faithfully in Vietnam. He has worked tirelessly as the co-chair of our committee to get this project successfully completed. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming co-chairman Dan Fisher.
How about that flyover? Good for air support. Mayor Mike Keene, council members Terry Furlong, Candy Peterson, Tom Sonic, Jan Walczak, former Councilman Scott Thorson, Congresswoman Betty McCollum, State Senator Chuck Wigger, Representative Leon Lilly, distinguished guests, citizens and friends of North St. Paul, and most importantly, honored veterans. The project committee gives you Veterans Park. Yeah. 5 years ago, the all-volunteer Veterans Park Committee was privileged to renew the challenge envisioned long ago by two World War II veterans, Ellsworth Erickson and Bill Crowther, to provide a place of honor recognizing the service and sacrifice of military veterans of the greater North St. Paul area. The tremendous public support, both financial and inspirational, through the purchase of memorial pavers, basically funded our efforts to begin construction of Veterans Park. We appreciate the in-kind donations, individuals with money, material, volunteer time, and labor. We appreciate the successful efforts of Senator Chuck Wigger, Representative Leon Lilly, and City Manager Jason Ziemer for getting us support for the State of Minnesota Bonding and Legacy Act funds. And this helped us complete the entire park in 2015. Not phases, it is all done at one time. We recognize Steve Knudsen of DSGW Architect for the unique and patriotic design that he gave us. We also appreciate the city engineer, Morgan Dolly, for his organization of our construction skills, and the real go-to guy, Scott Dudick, wherever he is, he's probably doing something and helping. The on-call guy helps you with everything you need. Thank you, Scott. And finally, we are thankful for the divine guidance granted our deliberations and our actions. When the sale of the first memorial paver started in June of 2012, Veterans Park grew to become more than a memorial to the service and sacrifice of individual veterans and servicemen and women. It soon became a story of generations of family and community service to our country. In fact, over 70% of the 565 pavers placed on the red walkways are in groupings of family, friends, buddies, and units, and they total over 130 separate groups. These groupings may be as small as two pavers or as large as one family that has 16 pavers. Truly a daunting task to keep record of, right, Tom?
Yes.
The memorial wall behind me commemorates the names of the Greater North St. Paul veterans who gave their last full measure in service to our country. On my right, on the walking path, is additional veterans' names as commemorated on the renovated World War I plaque from the Cannon Park days. Along the outer walkway, there's 10 podiums that give the history of our nation's conflicts intertwined with the city's history and the sacrifices that we all give. It's a story of sacrifice and support by local families who see their loved ones off to serve and protect our great nation while waiting anxiously back home for their return. The colorful patriotic emblems of the park that comprises Veterans Park are inspired by our national flag, which veterans all serve under. The powerful image of the U.S. veteran etched in Minnesota mined black granite right before us invites passersby to come forward and witness all veterans' names engraved on the memorial wall. This valiant image, caught in an instant on digital photography in 2010 by a military photographer, is garbed in the battle dress of the modern era, as many of you out here have worn veterans of our more recent conflicts, and also by our three most recent honored names on the wall. Sergeant Chad D. Frocher, United States Marine Corps, Specialist 4, Gregory B. Rundell, United States Army, Specialist 5, Matthew J. Johnson, United States Army, whose families join us here today. They're among the crowd, but up here at the podium, there are two from each family. These three families were instrumental in the donation of the four flagpoles behind me, given to Veterans Park by David Larson of Flags for the Fallen Military. If you could all give them a big round of a hand. The volunteers of Veterans Park Committee, thank you all. Our veterans, thank you, and the country thanks you. And finally, to the veterans who stand with us here today, and those who stand with us in spirit, we salute you.
Thank you, Dan. Our next guest speaker is Minnesota Congresswoman Betty McCollum. Congresswoman McCollum has been an advocate for veterans in Washington and a good supporter of veterans and veterans groups at home. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome me in welcoming back home North St. Paul's own Congresswoman Betty McCollum.
Thank you. Good morning. Congratulations to everyone, all the names that you listed, everyone back here, and a special thank you to the families who helped with the flagpoles. This is just truly an amazing day. Makes me so proud to be from this community, because we are about community. We're about one. We're about helping each other. And if you think about the sacrifice that our servicemen and women make, They do it for one country. They do it for one constitution, yet they do it for all of us. I can't thank you enough for making this a park, as you described it, Tom, to the rest of us, because as our Park Service celebrates its 100th centennial, we can go out, click on this park, and say, find this park, and people from all over across the United States and the world will know what this community and these volunteers did today. So go out to the website, National Park, find this park, mark it, because today is truly a day of remembrance. As I was sitting here and you were reading the names of the fallen from Afghanistan and Iraq, I remember the first times I was in theater. Imagine it literally 20 degrees hotter than it is today, wearing armored gear to protect yourself. And then being out on patrol, and then knowing that you have people back home that are worried about you, concerned about you. So our thanks not only to our veterans, but our veterans' families. But today is an emotional day for me for a couple of reasons. One, my father was from South St. Paul. I know you've all forgiven me for that. But he was in the Army Air Corps. And so hearing and seeing those planes, my father was with me today, and I got to thank him for his service. Also, by being here today and working with Carl and some of the others, I'm an auxiliary member of the VFW and the American Legion, we realized that there were a couple of names, and Carl was standing up for one of them, a dear friend of mine, to make sure that they're on. And I want you to know this morning I called Karen Sandberg, and there will be a marker on here for his honor, Mayor Sandberg. Karen and I'll take care of that. So thank you for including me in today, but most importantly, thank you for being part of a community and a nation, the freest country on earth. Yes, we have our struggles, but I have to tell you, everyone admires the fact that we're still fighting for our freedoms here and that we stand for freedoms all around the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Congresswoman McCollum. Our next guest speaker is State Senator Charles Wigger. Senator Wigger has been instrumental in helping us secure bonding and legacy funds needed for the park. Please join me in welcoming Senator Charles Wigger.
Thank you, Commander Trost, and past commander, but you're always a commander in my book. And honored veterans, your families, friends, community. This is community spirit at its best. This is patriotism at its very best. And I'm so proud that on a personal note, I can share in this with parts of my family that are here today, that'll be in the papers. It's a part of history, just as you are here. Growing up just on 12th and 3rd, as that's where my parents raised me as well, I always knew about the patriotism of this wonderful community through the Legion and the VFW, the auxiliary groups. And reading more into history, I knew that this whole community has always practiced what it talks about. Henry Castle, you see a picture of him here, the founder. He was Captain Henry Castle. He served in the Civil War. And just one brief thing about history. Imagine it was 20 degrees right now. That might be kind of nice. That would be 98 years ago, and this is true, I just read about it in North St. Paul's history book. Most of the community gathered. There was a banquet, and they were sending off to war 14 teenagers, young men, off to war. 1918, right before the end of the war. And they had a parade coming right down Margaret Street. Now, Don Regan, you weren't there, were you? No, okay, no, excuse me. Okay, anyway, they're marching down, and some of you might remember, there was a train station out here. Anyone remember that? And they had the train waiting. They sang, I think it was a Mr. Zwicky, did the Star Spangled Banner, the Lugers gave them a little extra greenbacks, as they call them, to spend. There was a lot of gifts and a lot of tears. And this community, most of it, they were all right out here about 100 years ago, just as many of our communities here today. So our roots are so deep, and the pride. And I'm happy we acknowledged what the World War I person, Rudolf Shockey, he did not return on that trip from the train. And by the way, the next stop then was White Bear Lake. On a personal note, I have several relatives that'll be here, and Ed Kropp, my uncle, served in World War II, Bill Kropp in Vietnam, who just recently passed away. My dad, my hero, George Wigger, who taught me the importance of community involvement, of patriotism. And he came back from the war with shrapnel in his head that they could never operate on and suffered every day, but always encouraged to support the community. And I'd finally like to just thank my daughter, Angelina Wigger. She went to North High, graduated. Do we have any North High grads here? Okay, Polars, and we love the rest of you too. But I'm a Polar, as were the parents and my kids. And Angie graduated from North High, was getting ready to go to college in the Guard. But once the attack on the Twin Towers, she said, during 9/11, she said, "Dad, I'm going active," and she was off to Fort Jackson. And soon thereafter, in Iraq. And many of you share that story, and we know of those that saw their kids not come back. Angie made it back, and she spent some time at the VA hospital, and we never knew if that 105 temperature was going to go down. But she was able to go back on the GI Bill and go to St. Thomas to get her master's degree, and is now a social worker serving veterans. And Angie's here. Angie, I love you. I just want to wave and say thank you, because you and the families that we represent, that's very, very important. So everyone, thank you. Commander Trost, mission accomplished. We're so proud. And to each of you, God bless you. God bless America.
Thank you, Senator Wigger. Our next guest speaker is State Representative Leon Lilly, who was also instrumental in helping us secure bonding and legacy money needed for this project. Please join me in welcoming State Representative Leon Lilly.
Thank you, Commander. Wow, what a day. Remember when he did the shovel breaking, and what was that, 20 below, I think? I was kind of teasing the mayor. I said maybe he could put a fan on the snowman and have it blow some air over here. You know, as a state representative for this area, it's really quite an amazing job, because you send us, Senator Wigger and Betty and the rest of us, to go do your work. And it's an amazing honor, and we feel lucky to do it. And one of the things I like to do is go down there and, you know, you guys come to us with ideas. And I remember when your team came to us with this idea, and Dan said, and the rest of the team, and they said, you know, we need some money. And they showed this cute little flyer, and they said, let's go get her done. And I'm like, and then in the beginning, they brought up Egan. And I don't know if you remember, the former mayor before Dayton was from Egan. And they got $100,000. So he says, let's go down there. And I remember thinking, oh man, here goes. So we went down, and it was kind of tough going at first. So we came up with the legacy. And I, with Senator Wigger, we came up with 9,900 and something. Not the 73 cents, but the rest. So, we came up with that, and I came back to Dan, and I said, yeah, and I was actually, I'm going to be honest, I was feeling kind of good, pretty good about myself. And Dan looked me in the face, he says, Egan got $100,000. So, and that's pretty much what his team, they were never happy. Looked you in the eye, they'd grab you, kind of like I was telling about Herb Erickson earlier. He used to grab you, strong grip, and he'd look you in the eye. Well, anyway, so we went back, Senator Wieger and I, and we were able to come through and get that $100,000. And the story is, the reason I'm saying it is, it's because of this team here. A lot of politics. I know you'll come as a surprise. We're in a political building, but ours wasn't at the top of the list, to be honest. There was this city, I don't know, I'm a hockey guy, so I'm going to name, you guys can figure it out, but they were cake eaters, and over in the West Metro, and they were going to get about $100,000 because, you know, let's be honest, it was a political year. Dan kept looking at me, and the team came down with the mayor and the city, and made a presentation, and they did such an amazing job. The chair, Alice Hausman, and the rest of the House members were like just struck by the force of this group and the presentation. I mean, look at this. This is unbelievable. It's even better than that fancy brochure, of course, but it's amazing. So, and actually, the questions weren't about this project. The other members on the committee were like, how'd you do it? What are you doing? So they wanted to bring this idea back to their community and kind of steal it and go with it. But hats off to your committee, and it's what a treasure, and I'm just happy to do my small part with Senator Wieger. But I just want a couple real quick things, because he told me to be really brief. But, you know, as a legislator, we got, early on, we had lost Mr. Rendell, and I see his family there, and I sat with Betty McCollum and Senator Wieger at the funeral, and, you know, when you realize how young that young man was, you know, in his 20s, early 20s, he probably hadn't even been into furlongs yet. You know, it's just amazing the price they pay. And I'm a runner, and I'm always, you know, well, they put the Rendell, I thought it was really neat they put him here. But then they've got, can't think of the guy's name, I'm having a brain deal. Who's the runner guy with the flag? Sheppers. From, well, he's not really from, isn't he a North High, right? So, I think he ended up in South St. Paul. But this guy is kind of what they're doing here. He, and that's the challenge for all of us too, I think, is to reflect. But he went around the country with a flagpole. He ran from California to Washington, D.C., 3,000 miles, telling his story. They told him when he was shot, he had a Purple Heart. They told him he'd never walk. And there he was. He's going across the country. I mean, that's from this sacred ground, this area. And that's what you guys are, the legacy these folks and others like him are leaving for us. And what a amazing legacy for all of us. But there he was. He's running across the country, did 18 marathons, carrying this flagpole. Please Google it and take a look at him. What a amazing man. But thank you for this. And what a blessing. Really hats off to your team. And I'm glad you mentioned Scott Dudick. I've seen his truck up here about 73 times. And just congratulations, and what a great community we have. God bless y'all.
Thank you, Representative Lilly. Our next speaker is a man who needs little introduction here in North St. Paul. Mayor Keene has supported this project from the very beginning and has been an advocate for this project anywhere he could. Please join me in welcoming Mayor Michael Keene.
Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for showing up today on this very warm day. But I think this is a day that will go down in history as one of the most important days in the history of our community. It's a wonderful opportunity to finally recognize the veterans and those who served in the military in our city collectively in one memorial, and I think it's a wonderful opportunity that we have before us today. I wanted to just talk about two things. I'm here to give thanks, and I'm also here to give honor. I want to give thanks to obviously the Veterans Committee, the City Council, the City Staff, the Park and Recreation Commission, our legislators, and all those who helped make this happen today. I also want to particularly point out a couple staff members. You've heard Scott Dudick's name. Scott was here all the time helping shepherd this through when he was still our public works director. We also, I want to give a shout out to Brian Frandl and the electrical department crew who did all the wonderful lighting. And if you haven't had a chance to drive by the memorial yet at night, please make a point of doing that after dark and see how the impact that the lights have on the memorial as well. It's a great service that those two staffers have done, and their departments as well. My hat's off to them. I also want to say that this was a tremendous collaboration. It was so wonderful to work with the veterans organizations, to work with Junior ROTC, to work with the Park and Rec, the city, everybody together, pulling together to make this happen. You know, as a someone who grew up in this town, I think those of us who are lifers here realize the VFW and the Legion have always been here for us. And you hardly even had to ask, and they provide money for youth programs and for different things throughout the community, ball fields, sponsoring scholarships, lots of great things that they've done, Boys State, Girls State, all those great things. And to me, and I want to have a round of applause for all of our veterans, particularly those in the post, because finally we got them to focus a little bit on themselves and work on a project that honors the veterans. And I salute all the veterans here. You know, it's about time is what I say, and I think it's long overdue. The other thing I obviously wanted to talk about was that we're here to honor our veterans and those who served in the military and those who are currently serving in the military. You know, as we dedicate this memorial, as I do so today, I want to let everyone understand this is hallowed ground. This is sacred ground now. This is a place to reflect, to come and remember our loved ones, to come and remember that freedom is not free. Please use it. It's a community park. We want you here. We want you to use it. And we hope it lasts until the end of time. And we really are proud of this. And please remember that this is your park. Please come and visit it frequently. But also, I think we also need to reflect and give honor to those who are mentioned here today on particularly the Wall of the Fallen. We all know freedom is not free. Just the U.S. military casualties, World War I, 116,000. World War II, 405,000. Korea, 36,500. Vietnam, 58,200, and almost 7,000 now in the Gulf conflicts of military personnel that we've lost in the line of duty, paying the ultimate sacrifice. So please, when you visit here, remember the Wall of the Fallen up there, reflect on those names. You know, it's interesting to see how those folks, too, were part of North St. Paul. I think one of the greatest tributes that anyone has ever given to our fallen veterans, and I want to shout out Mr. Ellsworth Erickson back there, who had this idea many years ago. Ellsworth, a few years ago, made a trip to Washington, D.C. to visit the World War II Memorial there. He lost three very close friends in World War II. My uncle, Eldon Keene, Richard Notabart, and Richard Newman. And when Ellsworth went there with his sons, he left the medals that he had gathered there at the memorial in their memory in behalf of them. I think that's just such an unselfish service to remember those. As he told me, he said, I don't have, they never had their life. I've had a great and long fulfilling life. I was fortunate. I came back. They did not, and I wanted to pay tribute to them. And I think, Ellsworth, that's just a tremendous sacrifice, and I thank you personally very much for that. And as I conclude my remarks, I also want to mention those disabled, those who have come back from conflicts, both physically and mentally disabled. They need our help. They need our support. We need adequate funding for the VA hospitals. I know Congressman McCollum has worked at that very hard, and we need to make sure that our veterans are taken care of once they've served in the military and went through a lot of stuff. I remember asking my... I remember asking my father, World War II vet, I said, you know, curious young kid, probably a stupid question. I said, Dad, do you ever remember shooting and killing someone? And, you know, those are tough times for veterans. And he said, he patted me on the shoulder and he said, I remember shooting at them, son. I don't remember ever killing anyone. Well, I now look back and say that's probably not true. But that's the way, you know, he looked at the difficulties that he went through and many veterans have gone through in serving whatever conflicts they've served in. And I think that the best way we can honor them is by coming here with having this memorial and paying our respect to them. And if they want to share stories, that's wonderful. And I think that that's something that I think we want to make sure that we recognize and support the returning veterans to the fullest possible. Not only disabled, but we can't forget the almost 85,000 POWs and MIAs that are still missing from all the military conflicts in this country. We can't forget them. I want to invite everyone on, hopefully I'll get this right, Wednesday, September 16th, the VFW will be holding a POW MIA parade. We'll march from the VFW up to the Legion and do a short ceremony up there, so that we keep that issue before the government, that we need to make sure that every POW, MIA are given the accountability that their families deserve. And lastly, I just want to reach out to the veterans, reach out to the families, and I know it's hot and I appreciate you sitting through all this today, but to thank the families for supporting their veterans. Whether they were your grandfathers and you just chatted with them and gave them comfort, whether I knew that was going to happen. What time is it? Yeah. You know, we love that fire whistle, though. That's another thing that makes North St. Paul, North St. Paul, right? But in conclusion, I just wanted to reach out to the families as well and thank all of the families for their support, those who bought stones of loved ones that are no longer with us, those that are there to comfort loved ones that have returned home from the current conflicts. And this is a great nation, and this is a great city. And I want to pass on to you my blessings to our country, our city, but particularly my blessings to the families of veterans and obviously in greatness the veterans who have served. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you, Mayor Keene. Our last speaker for today is another person who needs a little introduction. City Council member Terry Furlong is active in everything about and around North St. Paul. He has been a driving force to put a group together that would take this dream of so many and turn it into a reality. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming City Council member Terry Furlong.
Thank you, Thomas. It's been an honor and a privilege to work on the North St. Paul Veterans Park. Over the past over five years ago, I was approached by Ellsworth Erickson to help him put a veterans park in North St. Paul. At that time, Highway 36 was coming through. This was all being dug up. We got the slip ramp here, kind of separated. We weren't sure what we're gonna do with the park. Ellsworth, your dream is still here, and Ellsworth, it's made. After that meeting and after all that, I approached Dan Fisher. Dan Fisher, I thought, great fit, VFW. I asked Dan, I said, Dan, it's a small project. It's just a veterans memorial. I mean, can't be a whole lot of work done. And Dan said, okay, I'll do it, as long as it doesn't take that long. So then I approached Carl Hirchin from the VFW, also a veteran. Carl also said yes. I went on next to Tom Trost. Tom Trost, a member of the American Legion. On to the JROTC, Brian Bujans and David Wilkinson, veterans and teachers of the JROTC program at North High. Our first meeting was held over at the district center here, up at the JROTC room, and we started planning. Our first couple of meetings, we made a recommendation to bring on Bill Crowther, veteran, who's with us here today in spirit, who's also a member of the American Legion. And Joe Zakreski, who worked on Oakdale's Memorial, brought him on board. There was also an attorney that worked for the Legion. I mentioned John Baker. I went over to John Baker's office and said, John, can you join us? Of course. So John joined us. We also approached Don Schroeder, who is a veteran, who has done many fundraisers. How about a North St. Paul historian Paul Anderson. I mean, duh. How easy is that? And then on to the Park and Rec, where we got Dave Andrin. And then we needed a designer, DSGW. Steve Knutson, also committed. These individuals will become and will now be known as the team. Through the project, every concern, problem, and decision was decided by the team. And I can honestly say we had many decisions that needed to be made. I could go on and on about the project, the thousands of emails, going to the Capitol, writing grants, car shows, Silver Lake Splash appearances, and Best is the Ultimate Wrestling match at North High. That's a whole story in and of itself. We raised over $240,000. Well, the past 4 years and how busy this committee has been, there is one individual who is not only a team member, but we all believe is the team captain. He has been the person who not only was the first person I asked to be part of the committee, but with his passion, dedication, commitment, enduring hours and hours of detail at home and at every turn, not only at the functions, but you would see him here at the start of the project to the very end. He was stationed at this site from morning till night, making sure the team was informed and that progress was being made. I'd like to invite the team up here at this time. The team, with all voting, aye.
Aye.
They didn't read their script. The team, with all voting aye, would like to recognize Dan Fisher as a team person going above and beyond his duty as a team member. Will Dan and Dan's wife, also join us up here? Okay, Jerry is disposed right now. But Dan, if you could join us up here. And the plaque reads, and this is a piece of granite, Mesabi black granite, which you see through the park here, that was taken out of Ely, Minnesota. So this is all Minnesota built. Dan Fisher, with grateful appreciation, we thank you for your outstanding leadership, selfless acts of time and dedication, and unwavering commitment to detail. You have gone above and beyond in tribute to all veterans. North St. Paul Veterans Park Committee, August 15, 2015. Dan, I present this plaque to you. Jerry, if you wouldn't mind, just a quick second. Come on, I see you there. Because not only does it take one person to build the project,
what?
It takes a wife to put up with his time away. How many missed dinners? Thank you for allowing us to have Dan for the last 4 years. So Jerry, we appreciate it. Thank you, everybody, and I really hope you do enjoy this park, because this is a wonderful thing for bringing North St. Paul into the future and just recognizing all of our veterans. So thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Furlong. At this time, representatives of the family of Gregory Rundell, Specialist Gregory Rundell, Army Specialist Matthew Johnson, and Marine Sergeant Chad Froker will join Mayor Michael Keene, North St. Paul Veterans Park, Inc., Co-Chairman Dan Fisher and Carl Hirchin to formally unveil the greeter statue. I've got just a few brief announcements. Special thanks to the Salvation Army for providing refreshments today. Jim Gross from Polar Ridge Senior Living for providing a shuttle. The Lions Club for providing refreshments. To the City of North St. Paul staff and the other volunteers in their efforts to do everything that happened today. There'll be a social time and a cake cutting ceremony in the banquet hall of the North St. Paul American Legion Post 39 across from Anchor Bank starting at 1 p.m. There are four junior ROTC cadets from North High that will be here to help you find your papers if you need that. If you find that there is an error with your paper, bring it to their attention and we will get that problem resolved. We will need your name, your phone number, and the name on the paver in question. A member of the North St. Paul Veterans Park, Inc. will call you back to verify the information, and all the new pavers that were received since March 31st, 2015, and the replacement pavers will be installed in spring of 2016. The invitations, how many people received invitations? Weren't they nice?
Yes, they were beautiful.
The invitations were sent out were designed and handmade by Barbara Vinnis of Coon Rapids. She handmade every card and envelope and donated all her time and materials. And again, thank all of you for choosing to take some of your day to honor the faithful and selfless service of these men and women who served our nation in war and peace through their military service. As you enjoy the rest of the weekend, I ask you all to remember the men and women, sons and daughters, nieces and nephews, mothers and fathers, aunts and uncles, grandparents, and yes, great-grandparents, who all day long today, as they did yesterday and will do tomorrow, have voluntarily been willing to be on duty around the globe, some in harm's way on freedom's frontier, so that we could enjoy ourselves and share in each other's company. Remember, my friends, that freedom, true freedom, is not free. Please remember them in your thoughts and prayers. At this time, Pastor Bonnie Wilcox from St. Mark's Church will give the benediction. Please stand.
Let me say what an honor it is to be with you today as I'm one of the newest members of this community. And as I think about this Veterans Memorial, I give thanks for my father, who was a World War II veteran and who was marked in the same fashion in a memorial in my hometown in Iowa. And so it's a wonderful thing to be able to drive by this and remember not only these veterans, but also those veterans I know in other places, including my dear father. Receive the benediction. God grant the living grace, and to the departed rest. This nation, those born on this soil, and those who come here from all corners of the earth, is on a continual journey toward its destiny. May we never let down those who have served in defense of this country. May we uphold the values of freedom, of the inherent dignity of every human being by our own right conduct, by the kindness and the tolerance we show to one another. May we lead the world by example and become, in the words of the prophet Isaiah, a light to the nations. Then will the labors and sacrifices of these veterans be honored not in words alone, but by our deeds. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your North St. Paul Veterans Park. Thank you for your attention and attendance, and have a great day.